Today's topic, Fundamental Theorem of Algebra. Example, find the degree and the number of zeros by inspection. Before finding the degree and the number of zeros by inspection, let us first read the Fundamental Theorem of Algebra. According to the Fundamental Theorem of Algebra, every polynomial function with complex coefficients has at least one complex real or imaginary zero. This Fundamental Theorem of Algebra as a corollary, every polynomial function containing a polynomial of degree n as exactly n zeros, including imaginary and multiple zeros. This means the degree is equal to the number of zeros. Let us have the first polynomial function. F of x is equal to 4x cubed minus 12x squared plus 9x. The exponent of x in the first term is 3. The exponent of x in the second term is 2, and the exponent of x in the third term is understood to be 1. The highest exponent is 3, so the degree is 3, and the number of zeros is also 3. Let's have the second polynomial function. F of x is equal to x squared plus 25. The exponent of x in the first term is 2. This is understood to be 25x raised to the exponent of 0. 2 is larger than 0, so the degree is 2, and the number of zeros is also 2. Let us have the third polynomial function. F of x is equal to x raised to the exponent of 4 minus 10x squared plus 9. The exponent of x in the first term is 4. The exponent of x in the second term is 2. This is understood to be 9x raised to the exponent of 0. The highest exponent is 4. The degree is 4, and the number of zeros is also 4. The first polynomial function is f of x is equal to 4x cubed minus 12x squared plus 9x. We said that the number of zeros is equal to 3. Let us find out if this is true. 4x cubed minus 12x squared plus 9x is equal to 0. Let us factor the left side. There is a common factor, which is x. Factor x out. 4x cubed divided by x is equal to 4x squared. Write 4x squared. Negative 12x squared divided by x is equal to negative 12x. Write negative 12x. Positive 9x divided by x is equal to positive 9. Write positive 9. This is still factorable. 4x squared minus 12x plus 9 is a perfect square trinomial. To factor this, extract the square root of the first term. The square root of 4x squared is 2x, right? 2x, 2x. And then the square root of the third term. Square root of 9, 3, right? 3, and then 3. Follow the sign of the middle term. Negative, negative. Let us check the factors by FOIL. First term times first term. 2x times 2x, 4x squared. Outer terms, 2x times negative 3 is negative 6x. And then inner terms, negative 3 times 2x is negative 6x. If we add them, the sum is negative 12x. Last terms, negative 3 times negative 3 is positive 9. So we have now x times the quantity 2x minus 3 times the quantity 2x minus 3 is equal to 0. Equate each factor to 0. So x is equal to 0, or 2x minus 3 is equal to 0, or 2x minus 3 is equal to 0. Transpose negative 3 to the other side. Change its sign from negative to positive. So we have 2x is equal to 3. Divide both sides by 2. So we have x is equal to 3 over 2. Transpose negative 3 to the other side. Change its sign from negative to positive. So we have 2x is equal to 3. Divide both sides by 2. X is equal to 3 over 2. The zeros are 0, 3 over 2, and 3 over 2. So there are really 3 zeros. 0 as a multiplicity of 1. 3 over 2 as a multiplicity of 2. The second polynomial function is f of x is equal to x squared plus 25. We said that the number of zeros is equal to 2. Let us find out if this is true. X squared plus 25 is equal to 0. Transpose positive 25 to the other side. Change its sign from positive to negative. So we have x squared is equal to negative 25. Extract the square root of both sides. The square root of x squared is equal to the square root of negative 25. The square root of x squared is x. How about the square root of negative 25? Is it positive 5? Positive 5 times positive 5 is positive 25, which is different from negative 25. Is it negative 5? Negative 5 times negative 5 is equal to positive 25, which is different from negative 25. The square root of negative 25 is equal to the square root of 25 times negative 1. 25 times negative 1 is negative 25. And then, extract the square root of 25. The square roots of 25 are positive and negative 5, and then square root of negative 1. But the square root of negative 1 is imaginary, and we just write I. Hence, the square root of negative 25 is equal to positive and negative 5i. So we have here x is equal to positive and negative 5i. The zeros of the function are positive 5i and negative 5i. So there are really two zeros. The third polynomial function is f of x is equal to x raised to the exponent of 4 minus 10x squared plus 9. We said that the number of zeros is equal to 4. Let us find out if this is true. X raised to the exponent of 4 minus 10x squared plus 9 is equal to 0. Let us factor the left side. X raised to the exponent of 4 minus 10x squared plus 9. Factor 9 into 2 factors such that the sum of the 2 factors is equal to the numerical coefficient of the middle term. Let us try negative 1 and negative 9. Negative 1 times negative 9 is equal to positive 9. Negative 1 plus negative 9 is equal to negative 10. Write x squared and x squared. X squared times x squared is x raised to the exponent of 4. After the first x squared, write negative 1. After the second x squared, write negative 9. Let's check. First term times first term. X squared times x squared is equal to x raised to the exponent of 4. Outer terms. X squared times negative 9 is negative 9x squared. Inner terms, negative 1 times x squared is negative 1x squared. If we add them together, we have negative 10x squared. And then the last terms, negative 1 times negative 9 is positive 9. So we have now the quantity x squared minus 1 times the quantity x squared minus 9 is equal to 0. Equate its factor to 0. X squared minus 1 is equal to 0, or x squared minus 9 is equal to 0. Transpose negative 1 to the other side. Change its sign from negative to positive. X squared is equal to 1. Extract the square root of both sides. The square root of x squared is equal to the square root of 1. The square root of x squared is x, and the square roots of 1 are positive and negative 1. Transpose negative 9 to the other side. Change its sign from negative to positive. X squared is equal to 9. Extract the square root of both sides. The square root of x squared is equal to the square root of 9. The square root of x squared is x, and the square roots of 9 are positive and negative 3. The zeros of the polynomial function are 1, negative 1, 3, and negative 3. 1, 2, 3, 4. So there are really 4 zeros.